Today's topic are recursive loops. Recursive loops are the only loops in KNIME Analytics platform that are able to work on data updated inside the loop body. In comparison, all other loops use a subset of the unaltered input data in each iteration. Here's an example for a recursive loop with a loop start node, a loop end node, and a loop body in between. The input of the recursive loop start node is only used in the first iteration as input to the loop. Starting from the second iteration, the loop input is the table received by the second input port of the recursive loop end node. The data received by the first input port of the loop end node are collected for the loop output. In the configuration dialog of the recursive loop end node, we have three options to define a stopping criterion for the loop: maximum number of iterations, minimum number of rows, and via a flow variable. The loop runs until one of the stopping criteria is met. The maximum number of iterations can be used to stop a loop after a set number of iterations. It is also used as an emergency criterion for the other options to avoid an endless loop, in case the stopping criterion is never met. The minimum number of rows ensures that enough rows are available for the processing in the loop body. The loop stops if the second input of the node has less rows than the set minimum. The last option ends the loop with a condition on a flow variable. The loop ends if the option is enabled and the value of the selected variable is equal to true. The configuration dialog has also some settings that define the node output. If the checkbox "Collect data from last iteration only" is activated, the node outputs only the data from the last iteration. This means that data from previous iterations are discarded. Otherwise, it concatenates and outputs all the data from the intermediate iterations. The second checkbox, Add Iteration Column, defines whether or not to add a column containing the iteration number. Another pair of nodes for a recursive loop are the recursive loop start and end nodes for two updated tables. The workflow passes two data tables from the recursive loop end to the start node. In this case, the data of the first port of the end node are passed again to the output, and the data of the second and third port are passed to the start node. The second table can, for example, be used to update flow variables to the next iteration. Besides this, all the configuration options are equivalent to the one in the recursive loop nodes with just one less data port. Let's now have a look at some examples where we want to use the results of the last iteration in the next iteration. In this workflow, the first meta node generates some time series data for the sawtooth wave to train a linear regression model. The goal is to use the model and the recursive loop to predict the values for the next 30 time steps. In the first iteration, the loop uses the last row of the training set without the target value. The resulting table consists of the prediction plus the 10 preceding values. We want to save this row for the loop output. Therefore, we connect the output with the first input port of the loop end node. For the next prediction, we don't want to use the oldest value, but the prediction and the 9 preceding values. Therefore, we delete the oldest value and feed the table into the second input port. We select the stopping criterion in the configuration window of the loop end node. In this example, we want to stop after 30 iterations, and we want to save all the intermediate results. Therefore, we set the maximum number of iterations to 30, and we don't activate the checkbox "Collect from last iteration only." After running the loop, we visualize the predictions with the line plot JavaScript node